Hi everybody! So I have been out shopping. I have been on a knitting festival in Fredrikstad. Then I have been a trip to Oslo and gotten a whole bag full of yarn and goodies there. And of course we have a small bag from Hobbii. After all, I am addicted to Hobbii. So now I will flip the camera down and let's see together what I actually got. So first, when we got to the knitting festival, we all was handed a goodie bag. So this is quite a big bag and it says welcome to the yarn house. I haven't been to this store. And that was actually quite good because then I got a bag to keep things in. So let's just empty that out and have a look what we got in that goodie bag. So first of all, we got a skein of yarn, some older, from Dale Garn. This is 100% wool. You can felt it. 5 millimeters knitting needles, washes, carefully of course because it is 100% wool. So this feels this is quite thick and it doesn't feel rustic, so it is quite soft for being 100% wool. Yeah, I never had this yarn, so I will be looking forward to just test it out. And since I only got one skein, I don't know how many meters it is, about 95 meters. So I don't know how quite what I can make with just one skein, but luckily I have some other yarn so I can complement it with to test it out. So I guess that a couple of mittens or something would be good. Yeah. Anyways, this one wasn't in the goodie bag, that I will come back to that. But we got this one, this is a measuring tape from Garnhuset. Just a regular measuring tape, so it shows centimeters on the one side and we have inches on the other side. So that is always handy to have extra. I often keep one in my project bag that I'm working with. And we have two catalogs from Sandnes Garn. This one is just showing all kind of the designs that that you have. Or that you can buy from Sandnes Garn. So this is just a portfolio, like a show catalog. And the this is theme 72, and this is theme 73. So this is called Norwegian Icons Sandnes Garn. The Norwegian yarn factory since 1888, so they have been around for quite some time. So of course they have beautiful sweaters in here. So this tells us what it is made of. Now this is thin merino wool, knitting needles 3, and it's called a ryggja sweater. Comes from 2 to 12 years, are being knitted down or from the bottoms and up. Yeah, so you get a little bit of info. So I guess that this, all of this is just children's clothes or sweaters. Yeah, so I don't really do anything with them since I really can't knit, and or I am actually learning, so I'm having a lot of fun learning that. Anyways, so some older yarn that I never used, I'll just put that back in the bag. So what did I buy? I found some that sold Fargespill yarn by Marte Helgetun. Now this yarn is just the softest there is, and it came in so many different colors, variegated from dark to light or light to dark, depending on which side you start it on. So this is 100% merino wool, not super washed, 150 grams. It's about 540 meters, and it says that one cake is enough for one small shawl. Knitting needles number 4. Come on, camera, you can do this. Come on, I'll stop it. Jesus, it just didn't want to. Yeah, so produced in Italy by Mondial for Holme and Helgetun. So this is color number 12. And I'm so sorry for my whining dog, but my female dog is in heat. She's now out with my daughter and my husband. So because my male dog is missing her, and I'm no good really. The other male dog, he is neutered, so he doesn't care, but my puppy is not. So anyway, about that. Then I visited the booth of Norspinn. That is a small yarn or small spinning company in Norway. Spinning alpaca, or they have alpacas, and they are spinning it and hand dyeing all the yarn. So this is Norwegian alpaca, come on camera, about 100 gram, 230 meters, come on camera, you can do it, terry threaded, as you can see. And this color is called Beringebærbær, which means raspberry poop. So I think those names is just the funniest there is. And of course we have the super cute alpaca. If my camera could focus, there you can see the alpaca. And the woman that actually has Norspinn, she was super nice. I believe that her name was Liz. So I talked about or with her as well. So this is just a small hank, a 50 grams hank, around 120 meters, but it is the same as this one. But this is called forest berry soup. So all of these are different colors, but I'm going to use them in a fade. So this third skein is also a 50 grams skein and just called forest berries. But look at these colors, and my camera actually picks it up very well. So Norspinn, she does a beautiful job, and this yarn is so soft and so nice. So it's so going to be like a shawl or a scarf for myself. I'm really going to yeah. Then I visited the booth of a bit of meat, and of course I lost something. Yeah, bit of meat. That is also bit of Mikkelborg. She has this hand dyed by Bitta. Happy parade, so I had to get this parade bag. So I'm going to crochet myself a parade scarf. I think this is just beautiful. This is 75% superwash merino and 25% nylon. 80 meter in 20 grams hanks, so it is around 120 grams in this bag. So here you can see the info to Bytta. Bytta.mis design on Facebook and Bytta.mis design hjemmefargeriet on Instagram. Hand dyed by Bytta. I really just love this color. Sorry for that glare. Yeah, and when I was or when I shopped at Bytta, she gave me a stitch marker as a small gift as well. So she asked me if I had dogs. Luckily I do. I have three dogs. So I got this one. Come on camera. Best parent, and it's picture of a little paw. Now isn't that just the cutest thing there is? I mean, and Bytta was so nice. Now she has a lot of books. Of course, yeah, knitting. This was a knitting festival, so yeah, she has a lot of books for different things. Yeah, and she was really nice. So I got that one. So and I also was I stopped by Mitchell's yarn. I did not buy any yarn from her. She also hand dyed yarn, but I found a stitch marker that I just had to have. Now this is another rainbow. Oh come on camera, there you can see a small rainbow stitch marker. I just thought that was just so cute, just had to have that. So let's put those in there so I don't lose them yet. Yeah, so now I will put some of this down. So that was what I got at that knitting festival in Fredrikstad. So my husband's cousin had a birthday, so and she lives in Kirkenes, which is quite far north, but she wanted to celebrate her day together with parents and family. So she decided to have the party and all in Oslo, just because that is easier. It is easy to have a meeting point for everyone. So of course me and Hubster took the terrain, and we have quite a lot of spare time. So then we were on a yarn hole. So we went from store to store, checking everything out, or not every store. I mean, Oslo is a big city, so, but we got to, I don't know, around five stores. Anyway, there was also what they called a city festival. So there was big sales on a lot of stuff. So I picked up, my god, I don't know where to put it, while I'm just let it sit there. So I picked up two of these big balls of, I don't know, yeah, they're not cakes, but yeah, let's call them balls for now, of Erle kid silk. I'm so sorry. Also from Dollegarn. Now this is 56% mohair, 26% silk, and 18% wool. So this is just so soft, but it's still warm, and it's very very furry. It is just so fuzzy that the thread itself is quite thin, but you can see all that fuss on it. And I was thinking that this will go very well together with the hand-dyed alpaca yarn that I got from Norspin. With this yarn. So I will pour like a shawl. Now this is soft as it is. So it doesn't need to have a kid silk, but I think that I would like to combine those two anyways. And I got this purpley color because I love purple, and I have a lot of purple things and purple yarn, so I will use it sometime for something. I have never tested out Selma by Permin. This is another hand dyed, but this is with organic colors. So come on, I wanted to test that out, and I'll look at these fall colors. I also thought that this this hank would be nice and go together with my one of the hanks that I got from Kvitlamme, which also had fall colors like orange and yellow and reds and brown. Now this is so nice. And the stats, it is 75% superwash merino wool, and we have 25% polyamide actually. So 50 grams is about 210 meters. Knitting needles 3. This is 31. So I'm looking forward to test that out, and it feels kind of rustic, but it is soft at the same time. So but of course it is soft because it is merino wool. Next up we have more purple. So this is Isager Alpaca 2. Now this yarn is so soft. It's made in Peru. It's just beautiful, and I love the color. When I saw the color, I was like, yes, I need at least one hank just to have it, just to touch it and look at it. I mean, this is beautiful. So this is 50% alpaca and 50% wool actually. 50 grams is about 250 meters, so it is like a normal sock yarn thickness. At least those hand-dyed merino yarns that I'm getting from Kvitlamme. So, hand wash, of course, it is alpaca. And so soft. I love alpacas. My God. Hamster, I am always looking for sock yarn. I stumbled over this. It's called Cash Sock from Jepard. Strong sock yarn with cashmere. Now you can read that, of course, yourself. This is English. Two hanks is like 30 pairs of socks normally, but I'm making him socks that goes up to his knees because he is Scottish and wears kilts. So he always wants long socks. Now they take forever to make, and of course this is black. I was like, really, do you have to have that color? I mean, I can't see it, I can't work on it at night, but anyways, I will have to make him a pair of black socks. So this is they recommend 2.5 to 30 millimeters knitting needles. You can see, read the stats there. 100 gram is 406 meters, so it is quite many meters on this. 70% merino wool, 20% polyamide, and 10% cashmere. Oh, this is so soft. And hopefully, it is the wrong as it says. So, the woman that worked on the store hadn't tested it out herself. But this is made in Italy for jepardgarn.dk. So it's made in Italy for a Danish company. So two skeins of that. Your two hanks, I mean. They also had these on sales. So now this is Drops Delight sock yarn print superwash 30 sock wool. Now I have some skeins of this already, some green ones, but I wanted these colors. Now that color is being flashed out. I mean, it is more like this. This color is actually more purplish than what my camera. And oh my god, my dog. Now he's howling for her. But yeah, and this looks more blue than it actually is. It is purple as well, or more like a lilac. Oh my god, just hang on. So let's hope that he is getting better. He got some candy or some goodies, so hopefully he will be working with that. Yeah, Drops Delight. I have other balls of this, but I haven't used it yet. So I picked up two of this. This is color number 14. Needles on hook size 3.5 millimeters. 50 gram is like 175 meters. Is that will be like 191 yards. Content 75% wool and 25% polyamide. So Drops Delight print. So this is the same color. And I got another color from that Drops Delight as well. Print. Now this goes in brown, and we can see a little bit of pink, some light green. Yeah, so if I'm opening up, it's like a flower. I mean, it's just beautiful. Look at these colors. So I got, now this is beaten up a little bit, but look at that, those colors. So this will be socks as well. I guess if not, they will work wonders for everything else, like mittens or hats or shawls or scarf and whatever. But I just love those colors. They're beautiful. So let me see if I can put them there. And I have heard other people talking about them, but I never seen it. Arvetta. So I picked up 30 scales of Arvetta. Now Arvetta comes from the Piccolana, so this is classic. Now this has the old band. They have come now with a new one, so they have that as well. But I kind of like the colors in this one. So Arvetta classic, 80% superwash merino wool, 20% nylon. So it can be, you can use it for socks. It is good enough for that, but of course for everything else as well. So this is color number 954, a light gray. Then we have a purplish, or more like a lilac actually. It looks more blue on my camera than it actually is. And of course another beautiful that red violet color. I just adore it. And it is quite soft. It is very, very soft. So this will work for everything. But I am amazed how thin it is. I mean, it is just and I'm so sorry for that today. It is just so so thin. So it will what does it say? It says knitting needles 2.5 to 3. Oh my god, can we, yeah, 2.5 to 30. So it's quite thin, but you can double it up with something else. For example, this kid silk, then it will be perfect. So yeah, that is what I got from Oslo. So 30 skins of Arvetta, 2 Drops Delight print in this color, 2 Drops Delight print in this one. Now this, I don't like how the camera actually show the colors, because it is It is much more purpley than what it actually shows some there. There you can see it closer, but this color is actually darker and more purpley. So, anyways, I have already talked about that. We have cashmere socks or cash socks. Looking forward to use that. It's again my beautiful alpaca. Let's put this away. This to also this kid silk and the kid silk. So that was all that I got in Oslo. So we have this small cute hobby bag. Now I have some Halloween yarn left over from last year, so I didn't get that much Halloween yarn this year, but I had to have some. Now this didn't say the colors. I was hoped that it actually did, but it doesn't. Anyway, so let's put that aside so that we can pull something out. Halloween sock wool glitter. Can we see the glitter there? There you can see. Look how sparkly it is. I'm just made or just finished a Christmas socks, or actually I am totally done with one and almost done. I only got the ribbing and the heel left on the second one in this Christmas yarn, and the sparkle is just amazing. It's beautiful. So this is Halloween sock wool glitter color number 4. It was I think it was called Zombie. So yeah, this is superwash wool. Let's read some of the stats. You can see it here, maybe. Halloween glitter sock wool, 73% wool, 25% polyamide. So it is stronger, and this glitter thread is 2% polyester. So this is a super fine yarn. They recommend a 30 millimeter knitting needle, so that is what I use for crochet hooks as well. So color number 4. That one ball of that one. We have another ball of that one, same stats but a different color. So this is color number 2. So this was just greens and black, light green, dark green, more of a neon maybe. It actually looks calmer on the camera than it does in real life. But anyway, this yarn is green and purple and red, violet and black. So light green and a darker green, and yeah, the same stats, everything. This is the same same yarn. So what is that? You can use a barcode scanner and get some info. So if you would like to pause this video and scan it, you can do it now. Guess that you are getting up some info about this yarn. So next up I got the Universe XL. Now Universe comes in 3 thickness. So Universe sock wool, which is the super thin, and then you have the regular one, and then you have the XL. So this is the XL, so this is the thicker one of those Universe. So this is 100 gram ball, 98% acrylic, and it is 2% polyester. 100 gram scales. It's actually a 30 weight, so it's 30 times the thickness of this softwood. In one cake we are getting 220 meters. That is around 240 yards. So again, you can scan the barcode. There you have it. and get some info, I guess. Beautiful. This is color number 3. I think I have several of my blue purple ones. So we always get a hobby candy. So this is so supposed to be the same color. Yeah, color number 3. Yeah. Purple, green, black, like light green, dark green. Purple and with some purple glitter in it. It's beautiful. So I crocheted myself a hat last year of a different color, and I just love it. This is just awesome. Yeah, so that is just this my small hobby haul for once. Now like I said, I still have leftovers from last Halloween, so that is why I didn't get as much, but I really wanted more sock yarn. I love crocheting socks now, always have one on the go. And those colors, beautiful. Yeah, and finally I bought a book. I ordered myself this from Sandra Gutierrez. I'm so sorry if I'm butchering her name. Colorful crochet knitwear. Now this is a beautiful book. Push that. Can we get it? I don't know. Where to put this there, maybe. So I can of course not show you everything in this book, but we can look at the content, and we can have a short look through it. So it she has an introduction, and she's talking a little bit about color theory and about different yarns and different color works techniques. So I really want to make crocheted garment that actually looks, or not looks knitted, but I want the same color work to make beautiful patterns. And yeah, so this tells us about the different stitches we can use. And let's just skip some. Now I'm testing out this one. Doesn't go that well as or yet, but I really want to like this sweater. I mean, this looks knitted. It is like a fair isle, I think. And believing that this actually is crocheted, it's just awesome. So and like this one, maybe let's see if we have it. Yeah, there. Now you can see it is beautiful, isn't it? And this is crocheted. So we have another, like a big sweater here. Now she has small tops and other things, hats, cowls, everything. Now this look like mosaic. crocheted, and it's just so much fun. But you also have more plain color works like this one. So yeah, it has a big variety of different patterns and techniques, and I just love that you are able to work with yarn more like a knitting. Of course, this one is not that hard. General techniques, abbreviation. Now I have marked off this page because I don't, yeah, I remember all the words and stuff, because I am from Norway, so English is not my first language. It is my second language. So so I kind of have to translate this book in my head while I'm working. So yeah, colorful crochet network, just a tip if you would like to have garments, sweaters and hats and all with the same Fair Isle look. So this is crochet knitwear. I think this just was such a remarkable book, so I just had to have it. That is it. Now this was a long video. I'm so sorry for all of you that likes the short videos. Did not manage to do that today. Hopefully, or but yeah, I'll probably be later. Anyway, I hope that you enjoyed all of this. And until next time, stay safe, take care, and I love you all. Thank you all so much for watching. I will see you all later. Bye!